Web search data says that a lot of shoppers are comparing between the Subaru Outback and Subaru Crosstrek, and if you're one of them, then you're in the right place.
Because I've crunched the numbers and made 41 calculations that you're going to want to see if you want to make the absolute most informed decision possible, and you're pretty set on buying one of these two machines or the other.
So full pricing up on your screen, but here's the gist. There is significant pricing overlap between the Crosstrek and the Outback, and depending on the trim, these two could wind up costing you the same despite being very different vehicles. In Canada, the Crosstrek Onix and Outback Convenience are actually priced identically.
With at least three trim grades overlapping on price, it's worth considering what I've got prepared for you so that you can make the absolute smartest decision possible on how to spend your money.
So let's kick off this very unique and detailed comparison by sizing these machines up. We know the Crosstrek is the smaller vehicle here, but exactly how much more space and volume do you get in the Outback for the same sort of money? Full specs on your screen, key takeaways. The Outback is 3.1 inches, 8 centimeters, or about 5% taller than the Crosstrek. And on overall length, the Outback leads the Crosstrek by a major 15.5 inches, that's 39.5 centimeters if you like, or a 9% advantage in overall tip-to-tail length.
So keep that in mind if you've got a smaller garage or parking space. It is over a foot of difference we're talking here.
On wheelbase, it's the Outback in the lead by 3 inches, 7.5 centimeters, or about 3% more distance between the front and rear wheels. The Outback is also 2.6 inches, that's nearly 7 centimeters, or just about 5% wider than the Crosstrek. That's with the mirrors extended, and both models have folding mirrors that can reduce that measurement by a few inches if you like. So in a nutshell, the Outback is mostly a lot longer than the Crosstrek, but also a little taller and a bit wider.
So what does that all mean for the dimensions inside?
Well, passenger volume in the Outback is 3,044 liters, with the Crosstrek coming in at 2,803, meaning the Outback's interior volume is about 8.6% bigger than the Crosstrek's. For your cargo, with all seats flipped up for use, the Outback provides 923 liters of space. That's versus 564 liters in the Crosstrek. Flip them down and the Outback can accommodate 2,141 liters of your stuff, with the Crosstrek trailing at 1,549 liters with the seats folded.
Translation? Well, for quite possibly the same amount of money, the Outback is going to give you 64% more cargo space with the seats flipped up and 38% more with the seats flipped down versus the Crosstrek.
That's cargo covered, and now for you and your passengers. It's the Outback with more front headroom, but by less than half an inch, actually just 0.8 of a centimeter, or an advantage of just 1%, so virtually a tie when it comes to front seat headroom. And that's using the headroom measurements with the sunroof for both models, by the way. It's also nearly too close to call for front legroom,
where the Crosstrek wins, but just by a hair.
In the rear seats, the Outback's long, flat roof give it another solid advantage. It's got the Crosstrek beat for rear seat headroom by 1.1 inches, 2.7 centimeters, or just about 3%. And that flat roof shape also makes it easier for you to transport taller items, maybe like a dog kennel, further up towards the front of the car with the seats folded. On rear legroom, the Outback leads the Crosstrek by 3 inches, that's nearly 8 centimeters if you like, or just over 7.5% for a major advantage in rear seat legroom for the Outback. So while their front seat measurements are comparable, the Outback's rear seat is going to be by far more accommodating for larger passengers, as well as taller cargo when the seats are folded down. And it gives you a significant advantage in overall carrying capacity versus the Crosstrek, so keep that in mind before you write a check. If you're after a little more useful information, let's talk cargo floor length. With the rear seats flipped up, the Outback has 9.9 inches, or 25.1 centimeters. That's roughly a 24% advantage in cargo floor length versus the Crosstrek. And with the rear seats folded, the Outback leads the Crosstrek in terms of cargo floor length by 11.1 inches, 28.2 centimeters, or about 17%. So now let's compare their fuel costs to one another, and this is my favorite part of these videos because I get to crunch a lot of numbers and share what I've learned, so here's what I've come up with. On average, to drive 100 kilometers, that's 60 miles in the Crosstrek, you'll need 8.1 liters of gas. That's whether you go with the base 2-liter engine or the more powerful available 2.5-liter engine. So you can pretty much just take the 30 free horsepower from the larger engine if you're thinking about it. They cost you almost nothing extra at the pumps. That's 29 miles per gallon regardless of the engine you pick. Now if you're Canadian paying $1.60 for a liter of gas like me, then driving 100 kilometers in the Crosstrek is going to cost you $12.96. If you're in the States, you're probably paying about $3.50 a gallon, and you probably call 100 kilometers 60 miles, and to cover that same distance in your 29 mile per gallon Crosstrek, you'll have to cough up something like $7.26. The standard 2.5 liter engine in the larger and roomier Outback needs 8.3 liters to drive 100 kilometers or 60 miles on average. That's just slightly more than the Crosstrek. And by my previous math, driving 100 kilometers in the Outback will cost you $13.28. In the US, it's a 28 mile per gallon combined rating, and by my earlier math, that makes it $7.49 to drive the Outback for 60 miles, basically an extra quarter versus the Crosstrek. So to summarize so far, in Canada, it'll cost you an extra 32 Canadian cents in fuel for every 100 kilometers you drive the Outback versus the Crosstrek, and in the US, that same fuel consumption penalty is about 23 American cents for every 60 miles. The average Canadian drives about 15,000 kilometers a year, meaning an annual fuel bill of 1,944 Canadian from the Crosstrek and 1,992 from the Outback. That's an annual difference of a whopping $48 per year for the average driver in Canada. If the average American drives about 14,000 miles per year, then that's an annual fuel bill of 1,690 American from the Crosstrek and 1,871 from the Outback. An annual difference of about 180 American dollars for the average US driver. The point here really is not to sweat the fuel economy between these machines when it comes to dollars and cents. The differences are very minimal. Just keep in mind that the turbo engine available in the Outback and the specialized Wilderness models available on both models can drive the gas bills up too. Specifically, the Outback's available turbo engine likes pricier premium gas and drinks it about 14% faster than the non-turbo engine on average, while the Outback Wilderness, which uses that same turbo engine, will drink on average 22% more gas than a model with the standard non-turbo engine, which runs on cheaper fuel.
So keep that in mind as you're setting up your fuel budget, and remember to allow for some extra gas dollars if you're choosing to go turbocharged or Wilderness package equipped.
But the comparison I'm most excited to show you is actually towing capacity versus fuel dollars. Both these machines have a maximum towing capacity of 3,500 pounds when properly equipped in selected trim grades and when powered by their up-level engine option. But when it comes to the standard, more mainstream models, the Crosstrek can tow 1,500 pounds, while the Outback can tow 2,700. So for shoppers looking to minimize their fuel costs who are not considering a turbo or Wilderness model, the Outback uses just 3% more of your gas dollars, but turns in an 80% advantage in towing capacity versus the Crosstrek. So how will you, or how have you, spent your dollars between these two machines, and what were the important factors you considered along the way? Let your fellow drivers know down in the comments section below if you're watching on YouTube, and we'll see you in the next video.